This brief video introduces the basics of preparing data management plans, or DMPs, for inclusion in grant funding requests. For help understanding data sharing requirements, preparing DMPs, or archiving and sharing your data, contact your liaison librarian, or Jeffrey Mortimore, Discovery Services Librarian, at jmortimore@georgiasouthern.edu, or 912-478-0102. Today, research funders increasingly require that the results of funded research be made publicly accessible, including research data. Funders expect researchers to actively encourage and facilitate data sharing, and increasingly require researchers to show how they will comply with these expectations by including a data management plan as part of their grant funding request. To maximize the likelihood of success, researchers should understand funders' data sharing requirements prior to submitting any request. The GSL provides an array of resources to help Georgia Southern students, faculty, and staff research and prepare DMPs, including information about funder requirements, example DMPs, and DMP templates for various funding agencies. These resources are available through the GSL's Data Management Services Guide at georgiasouthern.libguides.com/data. Prospective PIs should always review the specific RFP, RFA, or PA for guidance when preparing any DMP. However, every DMP should cover at least four basic topics. First, every DMP should provide a general description of the data expected to be produced over the course of the research project. This discussion should include a brief, non-technical description of the data that the project will produce. This should be a non-technical description that provides a general idea of what data will be generated throughout the research project. If the proposed research involves obtaining data from other sources, provide a brief description of the data, including its content, sources, and any conditions for obtaining and using the data. If applicable, describe your plans for redistributing any derived data products. Also, indicate which data you will share and at what stage, and describe why the data will be of interest to the broader community and how your plan will maximize the potential for its reuse. Second, describe how the data will be managed during the active phase of the research project. This discussion should describe how data will be collected and processed, including any quality assurance or quality control procedures. Identify the formats of data files created over the course of the project, including the approximate volume of data. Describe how data sets will be organized, how data will be distributed among files, file naming conventions, directory organization, and version management. And describe how data sets will be stored and backed up during the project, including hardware, storage environment, and local or external services to be used. If applicable, include the costs for these services in the proposal budget. Furthermore, if your research is subject to oversight by the Institutional Review Board, refer to applicable requirements and describe how your data management practices will ensure compliance. Identify who will have access to working data and how access will be managed. For sensitive data, describe the security measures and any formal standards that will be used. And lastly, describe what metadata will be created or captured, when it will be created, and who will create it. Third, describe your plan to share your data, including describe how the data will be made available, for example, via disciplinary data center or repository, an institutional repository, as supplementary materials supporting a publication, or some other strategy. Include a description of the file formats to be used for the data that will be shared, select file formats for sharing and archiving that maximize the potential for reuse and longevity, and describe the plans for conversion to those formats if necessary. Include a plan for creating metadata to describe the data. Indicate who will create metadata and when they will do so. Identify the standards that will be used. If no applicable standards exist, describe what supplementary documentation you will make available to make the data usable by others. Furthermore, describe conditions for reuse of the data by others. Describe any standard licenses that will be applied to the data, as well as any additional terms of use. Describe how users will discover the data, for example, via a specific repository, references and publications, a project website, internet search engines, or any other means. Describe how users will obtain the data, for example, by direct download, registration and download, or upon request. If you are acquiring data from another source, describe whether the data or any derived versions of the data will be shared and under what conditions. Also, if data will not be made immediately available, indicate when data will be shared. Indicate who will have primary responsibility for the data and who owns the data. And lastly, describe how your data sharing strategy will maximize the value of the data to the audiences of interest. Fourth, describe your plan to preserve your data, including identify any departmental, institutional, or programmatic policies on data retention, how they will influence your plan, and how you will adhere to the policies. Also, explain the criteria that will be used for selecting data for retention and preservation, and specify how long data will be retained or preserved. Some data may only be retained for the lifetime of the project. Some may be retained for the project plus a specific number of years, and some may be worth the effort of long-term preservation. In doing so, consider what data are needed to validate the research, what data directly support publications based on the research, and what data have the greatest potential for reuse by others. Furthermore, include a description of file formats to be used for the data that will be shared. Select file formats for sharing and archiving that maximize the potential for reuse and longevity, and describe the plans for conversion to those formats if necessary. Also, include a plan for creating metadata to describe the preserved data. Indicate who will create metadata and when they will do so. Identify the standards that will be used. If no applicable standards exist, indicate this and describe what supplementary documentation you will make available to make publicly shared data understandable and usable by others. And lastly, describe plans for transfer of responsibility should the need arise. Again, the GSL strongly recommends that researchers review grant funder requirements as well as consult example data management plans when preparing any DMP. These resources are available through the GSL's Data Management Services Guide at georgiasouthern.libguides.com/data. Of course, the GSL is here to help with funder and publisher data sharing requirements, preparing your data management plans, and archiving and sharing your data. For help, or to learn more about our data management services, contact your liaison librarian or Jeffrey Mortimer, Discovery Services Librarian, at jmortimer@georgiasouthern.edu or 912-478-0102.